Jason Ma. I'm a serial entrepreneur. My life story is quite interesting. So when I was seven, my dad asked me what I want to be when I grow up. In Cantonese, 广东话, he said, hey, 你想怎么样? What do you want to be? So I took out a white piece of paper, and I took out some crayons and a pencil, and I drew three pictures of myself. The first picture was me in a business suit with a tie and a suitcase. The second picture was me with a French Pierre cap, a paint palette, and a paintbrush. And the third picture was me behind a church pulpit with the crucifix behind me preaching. So my father asked me, what is this? It's a small, you know, Malik. I said, well, Dad, Monday through Friday, I want to be a businessman, an entrepreneur like you. Saturday, I want to be an artist. And Sunday, I'm going to be a preacher. So my father said, "Sengmozai, smart aleck." Fast forward 30 years later, that's what I do. So different phases of my life, I've had different seasons where now I'm an entrepreneur. I've started over 5 companies. For one period of my time, I was an artist. I like Shiha rap, so I rap and do spoken word. And for a period of my time when I was 20s, I was a missionary in over 40 countries. And so that's kind of the foundation of my calling or purpose from a child. But I always say, if you want to make God laugh, tell him your plans, because they never end up the way you think they're going to end up.
人称嘻哈牧师的马正远，在青少年时曾经偷窃、吸毒，并且差点入狱。然而，却因着上帝的恩典，让他获得重生的机会。而后致力用媒体来宣教，并且以福音改变世界。让我们一起了解马正远的非凡人生。
So I grew up, you know, mainly in the streets, and I, you know, was kind of a trouble kid. You know, some people might say I'm a guatai. You know, I was hanging around with a lot of local street gangs, and I got into a lot of trouble. I got kicked out of 3 high schools, but my 4th high school is where I had a turnaround story. And so at the time, I was basically on my way to jail, and I was 17 years old at the time. And I had basically been arrested twice. I really didn't listen to my mom. My mother was Christian. She would pray for me all the time. And she would always say, Jason, change your life. You know, God above is giving you a second chance. And you should do something with what God's given you. I didn't listen. It would go in one ear, out the other. But my junior year in high school, I got caught stealing at a store that I was working at that sold Giorgio Armani suits. And they were very high-priced suits, and me and my 2 other coworkers were laundering them to make side cash. At that moment, you know, I had, for a 17-year-old or 16-year-old, I had money, you know, I had cars, I had friends, you know, I had everything a teenager could want at that time, as far as money, drugs, you know, whatever I could access. And something inside of me said, even though I have everything, I feel like I have nothing. And I felt very empty inside. And I didn't know why. And I just felt like something needed to change. And I didn't know what it was. And so I said a prayer for the first time. And I said, God, if you're up there, please give me a second chance and let that cop, the policeman, have mercy on me.
然而，神奇的事情发生了。Jason 前后去了3次法院。而法官最终完全赦免了他的罪，不用坐牢的他，获得重生机会的他，找到了人生的新方向。
I walked in a criminal, I walked out a free man. I found a new purpose in life. I felt that the heavens had given me a second chance. So I found a new inspiration to do good, to serve my community, to serve other young people that were struggling like me. So I stopped dealing drugs, I stopped stealing.I got out of the gang activity, and I started going to church, and I started a Bible study in the area that I lived in San Jose, California. And because I liked hip-hop culture, I liked breakdancing and rapping and graffiti art and DJing. I thought, how can I get kids off the streets to find a purpose in life and find faith? So I started a Bible study where they would study the Bible for an hour, and after that they could pour out the breakdancing linoleum, and they could breakdance and rap and DJ till midnight at this empty church that I would rent out. And I went from, you know, being a drug dealer, you know, getting into fights on the streets, and all of a sudden I had straight A's. You know, I was taking my friends from the streets to church and changing their lives. And I said, God, you're the nicest guy I've ever met in my life. And I said, I don't want to serve myself anymore. You know, I want to serve a higher purpose. And so that began my journey from bad to good, or from dark to light, 20 years ago. And so since that time, I remember telling myself, or telling God, I said, I really just want you to use my life in a way where I can help other young people like myself at the time to find a higher purpose, to find a higher calling, to get them from their troubles into something greater and better for the world. So that's kind of how my journey started.
This is my sister, Renee. I was just walking around the street and just thought I'd talk to her and get to know what's going on with her and what's going on with the hood here. And,
I'm drinking right now, but it's a good thing that Jesus Christ got a lot of assignments to do
for him. I need some money now. I can't even get on the bus, girl.
You need some money? You know what? I just got some money. I got some change right now. Can I pray for you real quick?
Please.
Let's pray for her real quick.
And I have a brother that's missing. So.
What's his name?
Ernest.
Ernest? All right. God, I just thank you today for being me.
最让我觉得他的人生生动而有意思的事情，就是我想他年轻也叛逆过，但是他能够在这个叛逆中自我追寻，去思考就是自己生命的价值，然后开始就是给自己做一个好的规划，能够学习专业，能够看清楚自己未来是要靠自己努力的，然后改变自己的心性啊，我想他开始工作的时候是本着这样的一个方向去努力，能够获得很好的成果，是一个其实在这个华人圈中是一个很不错的一个创业家，我想这是最大的意义。而在这样的一个过程中又能够有很好的心态去帮助更多的人，就是这种推己及人的这样子的一个心，我觉得是很多年轻人其实可以去参考和仿效的，特别是在美国这样的华人社会中的确不容易。
To me, success is doing what your purpose and called and created to do. If God created you to be a dancer, dance. If God created you to be a computer engineer, type code. If God created you to serve your country through government and politics, serve well. If God created you to sing your best. So God created every person for a purpose. Every one of us are designed for a specific task or destiny that only you can do. So success to me is not becoming rich or famous or having a lot of fancy cars and nice houses and millions of followers. Success is doing what you're called and created to do, being the best version of who you are.And the only person you should compete against is no one else but yourself.
高中毕业后的 Jason 致力于嘻哈读经会，更在此同时认识了深深影响他未来道路的导师 MC Hammer。MC Hammer 是1990年代当红说唱歌手，售出了1亿张唱片，并且成为第一个得到钻石成就的说唱歌手。著名歌曲包括 You Can't Touch This 和 Too Legit to Quit。当时的 MC Hammer 开始了生命见证，每周会跟上千名年轻人谈论信仰。
At the time, he had left Death Row Records, which was the same label as Tupac and Dr. Dre, and he had an encounter with his faith, and he started preaching at a big church in Silicon Valley, and every Sunday night I would listen to him talk to 3,000 men about faith and character and leadership. And so I thought to myself, I had this hip-hop Bible study where there's hundreds of young people from all over, you know, the impoverished neighborhoods, and MC Hammer speaking every Sunday night at this big church. I thought to myself, wouldn't that be so dope if I had a big hip-hop event to reach out to all the young people in the South Bay? and invited MC Hammer to come speak.
然而，出乎意料的 ，MC Hammer 除了是歌手、布道家，更是一名创业投资者。他们认识后 ，MC Hammer 甚至邀请 Jason 为他工作，并借着这个机会 ，Jason 了解整个科技创业公司的生态，并埋下了他未来职涯转变的种子。
He just introduced me to this whole world of technology startups. And so we were at YouTube, but it was only 5 people. I remember when Hammer met Twitter and Jack Dorsey, and it was only 3 or 4 people. He was at Salesforce with Mark Benioff when it was, you know, less than 100 people. And so we saw the Silicon Valley technology 2.0 revolution. And he would say to me, Jason, it's all about rich content and digital distribution in 1997, 1998.And he said, Hollywood is gonna go down. He says, the film industry is going down, the music industry is gonna go down. Everything's coming to Silicon Valley in 1997, 1998.
某一次 ,MC Hammer 因缘际会资助了当时默默无名的亚裔导演 Justin Lin 执导的电影 Better Luck Tomorrow。当时的 Justin 希望用这部独立电影翻转亚裔在西方主流媒体的刻板印象。而这项投资也激发了 Jason 事业的新热忱。投入亚洲媒体产业的推广。
You know, most of the time when you were watching a Hollywood film, you know, the Asians would be the gangsters or the geeks or the goonies or the geishas or just female sex symbols. And he says, that's not the true nature, that's not the true perception or perspective of our culture. And we need to change that through media. And Hollywood's been demonizing that, sensationalizing that, and not saying the truth. So at that time, I felt my calling was to leave venture capital.And pursue this mission and this vision to represent Asian culture in mainstream media the correct way.
满怀期待想去 Hollywood 闯荡的 Jason 却遇到了抉择，是否要离开他所培育的嘻哈圣经研究小组，远赴洛杉矶投入娱乐产业呢？
So literally, I was stuck in this dilemma where I had Hollywood in one hand and I had church mission work in the other hand, and I was totally conflicted and confused.And so I remember I went back to MC Hammer, my mentor, and it was the best advice I ever got my entire career. He said, Jason, if I were you, I would go serve God and do God's work. He said, Hollywood's always going to be there. He said, but if you go to Hollywood in the spiritual state that you're in right now, those demons will eat you up. You won't come out alive. And he said, do God's work first.Lay a strong foundation, build your character, serve the poor, serve God's people. And if he calls you back to Hollywood, instead of it influencing you, maybe you can influence it. So when he said that to me, it just made sense. And I knew that was the right thing to do at that time, that I wasn't ready for Hollywood and the temptations and the sex and the drugs andYou know, just all that comes with entertainment and showbiz. But truly to go back when I was ready or if I was deemed ready. So I said, okay, I actually ended up going to Bible college. I graduated summa cum laude, 3 different degrees. I had a youth culture degree. I had a Bible and theology degree, but I also had a business management and leadership degree.And then after that, I went to get my master's at Fuller Seminary and in Pasadena. Going from startup venture, wanting to go into Asian media and Hollywood, but then getting called into mission work. So I ended up going to 40 countries and I started schools, orphanages, hospital health clinics, churches in over 40 countries during my early mid-20s.For about 4.5 years. Leaders don't live for themselves, they live for others. You know, true leaders want to create a better society. True leaders want to solve social ills. True leaders empower others and mentor others and help others.Become leaders. The definition of a leader is service. It's about serving your faith, serving your country, serving your community, serving your wife or your husband, your children, serving the next generation.
Jason 在这些年带领了无数的青年找到信仰，他成立教会，参与布道，并且传福音给许多当红演艺人员，包括吴建豪、陈冠希等等艺人也因着 Jason 的带领接受福音。
When Jesus spoke to the masses, he wasn't preaching to the church choir. He spoke to the masses with parables or stories. So I thought about it for a moment. And I was like, wait a second. If Jesus was alive today, I think he'd be a talent manager. He would manage talent, those who can influence. If Jesus was alive today, he'd probably be a director, a movie director, or a storyteller.Because a modern day parable is a story without any religious connotations or context, but just a story that people relate to culturally. And if you listen closer, there's a lesson to be learned. There's a wisdom to be understood. So all of a sudden I realized, wait a second, Jesus was a talent manager and he was a storyteller. And that's how he changed the world. Church is about a relationship with God and others and yourself.And when people are activated and actualized to do what God created them to do, then the world becomes a better place. So what happened was I switched my ministry from the church at that time and being a missionary and speaking to thousands. And all of a sudden, divinely, I remember around 2007, different Asian influencers or talents or celebriesstarted coming to ask for help.
In Taiwan, throw one finger up in the air if you believe in love. This is one love.
Jason 有一个很大的宗旨，就是他觉得他在这边告诉大家的目的是主要是影响这个娱乐界。
全场欢声雷动，就像是参加摇滚巨星的演唱会，连艺人萧亚轩都兴奋地跟着一起附和。到底是谁让萧亚轩这么嗨？就是这位穿着黑色皮衣、一副黑人嘻哈风格的马正远。你能想象他竟然是位牧师吗？突破传统仪式，用的是创新的饶舌 rap 来传道。现在他还跨界拍电影，找来 F4 的吴建豪友情演出。现在马正远从牧师、歌手到导演，这位来自美国加州的饶舌牧师，正颠覆传统，震撼宗教界。
Jason 借着分享自身经历，给予艺人朋友陪伴和支持。带领他们走过演艺的低潮，而上帝透过 Jason 来把福音带给这些失落的人，带领他们走向全新蒙福的人生。
God forgives everyone, and God can use anyone if they're willing to be forgiven and to be used. When you work with people, whether they're homeless or whether they're wealthy and a billionaire, or they're just an average retail worker.Or, you know, a 9-to-5. Don't look at people's sin. Look at their heart. Don't look at what they've done. Look at what they can do. Accept people for who they are, not their past or what they have now, or who they know. But love and accept unconditionally every person you meet the same way you want to be loved and accepted. And therefore, if you give others that type of unconditional love,They are able then to not be afraid to fail and to believe in their God-given purpose, fulfill it, and make an impact in the world.
在世界各地宣教的 Jason 仍未忘记他最初想要投身中西文化娱乐交流的理念。
I remember to myself, the only way I'm going to reach the young people of Asia, the young people of China with a positive message, with a message to change their lives and make something of their future, is got to be through digital,It's got to be through media, and it's got to be through mobile. And so at the time I said, you know what? I think I need to go back to my calling, and I need to go back to media, go back to technology, go back to content. You know, I always remember this quote by Allen Ginsberg, a very well-known philosopher in American and world history. He said, whoever controls media controls the minds and the behavior of the culture. And so I knew thatthe medium to actually impact the world, to change behavior, values, decision-making, future leaders, is through the medium of media, to communicate through stories, through talents.
是音乐语言呢，它是没有国界的。我们心中理想文化的路径能够借由音乐来传播，但是你以我们自己国人来说的话，我们有这么强的文化底蕴，有这么多优秀的年轻人，不管是在各个领域，体育也好，或者是这个艺术范畴的也好，都有佼佼者。当这个体系形成的时候，我们是不是也有更多的机会来去做这样子的一些优秀的文化输出？这些需要过程，非常漫长。那做这样的工作的人，你必须有耐心，而且必须要很清楚的认知我们自己追求的是什么。我觉得这样才能路走得长。
Jason 从亚洲的福音事工回到洛杉矶，投资了一家媒体娱乐公司，认识了远东运动和 MC Jin。而 Jason 也成为其中的一人。当远东运动的 Kev Nish 为他录制饶舌歌曲时，却发现了 Jason 的独特之处。
But you know, when you preach, when you pray, you know, he goes, it's really powerful. He said, you ever thought about just like preaching or speaking over the hip hop beat? I said, what do you mean, like talking? He's like, yeah, do you have any of your sermons on YouTube? And I was like, yeah, tons. I was a missionary. I spoke all the time to young people around the world. He was like,Play one of your sermons on YouTube over that hip hop beat that your friend gave you and just see what happens. So he plays his beat and then I play my YouTube sermon over the beat. And it's like heaven touches earth and it lands in this crazy cadence. His hair starts standing up. He's like, holy crap. He's like, you're like Billy Graham, Joel Osteen and Eminem smashed into one. And I'm like, what? And he's like, can you do this in the studio? I was like,Of course I can. I've been preaching forever. He was like, get in the studio tomorrow night and just record. So I go to the studio and I lace three different verses without writing anything. One take, 16 bars, finish the song.
What true love is. Now Hollywood wants to make you think they know what love is. But I'm gonna tell you what true love is.Love is not what you see in the movies. It's not the ecstasy. It's not what you see in that scene.
为了让歌曲更有传唱度，他们邀请了当时仍未大红的 Bruno Mars 为 Jason 的歌曲唱副歌。
And he was like, okay. He goes, Jason, I got you a deal. I was like, how much? He was like, $1,500. He'll write and record four tracks and sing the demo for you. I was like, done. So I write a check, $1,500 to Bruno Mars. I still have the check stub.And Bruno came in, laced the tracks, and it was like magic, 24 karat magic. And I was just like, what? And so we had this one song called Love with me doing my spoken word, preaching, rapping, and Bruno Mars on the track.
Bruno Mars 现在是美国知名全方位音乐创作人，以复古流行兼具的曲风和极具辨识度的唱腔闻名。除了有数百万张的专辑销量，他的单曲销量更超过一亿。Bruno Mars 至今获得五项格莱美奖的肯定，也曾荣获《时代》杂志评选为全球百大影响力人物之一。Jason 当年和 Bruno Mars 合作曲，展现了他们独特的魅力。
We release it on YouTube, and overnight it gets 1 million views. And I'm just like, totally surprised. Next thing you know, Far East Movement, a few months later, makes a song called Like a G6. You might have partied to it in high school or college. And it became the number one hit song in Billboard charts around the world.
透过歌曲的大红 ,Jason 看见了亚裔音乐及娱乐在欧美主流市场发展的潜力。更因此奠定了他想要融合东西媒体文化的理念。下集我们将带您一探更多 Jason Ma 的非凡人生，在他风光的投资路上却遭遇到意想不到的低潮，而他将如何面对事业以及身心灵的挑战呢？Thank you.